Father God, we come to give your name praise on today, Father God. Father God, you are merciful God. You are great God. Father God, you woke us up in our right mind, Father God. And Father God, that's enough to say thank you, God. Father God, we just came to lift your name up, Lord God. Father God, we just praise your name, God, because you're worthy to be praised, Father God. Anoint this choir, Lord God. Anoint the leader of this house, Lord God. Pastor Henderson, Lord God. Touch him, Lord, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, Father God. Bless his helpmate, Father God. Touch her, Lord God. Bless her, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Oh, God, we just thank you for, Lord. Thank you for the service, Father God. Thank you for this choir, Lord God. Father God, thank you for the members, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we not get consumed by what we see, Father God, because our faith is in you, Father God. Your Bible said, without faith, it's impossible to please him, Lord God. Lord God, we give your name praise, God, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it seems like, no matter what you see on TV, Father God, our faith is in you, Father God. And Lord, for that, I give your name praise. Lord, for that, I give your name glory, Father God. Father God, if we've done anything outside your will, we God is sorry, and we repent right now, Father God. Remove all stain and sin, Father God. We thank you, Lord God. Father God, we pray for the first responders, Lord God. We pray for the ones in the nursing field, Father God. The medical field, Father God. Bless them, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father God. We give your name praise. We give your name glory, Father God. Because all the glory belongs to you, Father God. Father God, it had not been for your grace and your mercy, Father God, where would we be, Father God? We just thank you on the day, Father God, you woke us up in our right mind. Because this is truly the day that the Lord has made. And we shall rejoice and be glad in it, Father God. So hook your heart for Jesus. Give God your best praise. Give God your best praise. He woke you up this morning. He started on your way, Father God. Father God, you we still living, Father God. But this virus didn't take us out, Father God. And Lord, for that, we say thank you, Father God. Our family is alive and well. We're alive and well, Father God. And Lord, for that, we give your name praise and glory and honor, Lord God. Lord, all the praise and all the glory belongs to you, Father God. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, Father God. Something we won't take lightly, Father God. But we give your name praise, glory and honor. Amen and amen and amen.
Good morning, TLP. Good morning, Facebook. Come on, begin to pop your hearts for Jesus this morning. Let's lift up a shout of Zion today. Hallelujah. God, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We need you to arise in this place, God. We want you to be glorified. We want you to be magnified. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We give you glory, Jesus. We give you glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. Your kingdom.
I believe in you. a break.
Welcome to our drive-in worship service at Tabernacle Praise Ministries. We are thankful that you are here with us today to worship in our parking lot and on Facebook Live. We thank all of you, including our visitors, who is present with us today. If you're new with us today, type connect in the comments. We would love to reach out and get to know you. For us, church is so much more than Sunday service, and we want you to know that there is a place for you here at the top. We invite you to engage in worship with us by singing and praising along. Please comment, like, love, and share the message. And if you would like to be a blessing to the ministry, there are a variety of ways to support our ministry. Every gift, no matter the size, is needed and appreciated. And here are the ways to give. Online, thetopministry.com. In person, the church, 289-6003. Cash App, $thetopministry. Mail your offerings to 3025 Wood Drive, Northeast, Centerpoint, Alabama, 35215. And please feel free to give at the end of the service. However, there are restrictions, and they are. There are 3 credit card machines, one in each foyer of the church and one in the foyer of the admin building. There can only be 1 person in each foyer at a time. Everyone is asked to remain in your vehicles until it's time to come in. At this moment, you want to prepare for ministry of giving. And if you would, raise your hand. A deacon with a basket will serve you. And I just want to speak to the members of TOP family. It is very important that we continue to support the ministry here that is going on at our church. Even though the church is closed, you know, but we are the church. And so we want to do whatever we can to support it. Like I said, there is the 6 ways that we can do that. And we need your support. And it's very much appreciative. Thank you. So continue to watch us on Facebook Live Sunday mornings at 10:30 a.m. and Wednesday nights at 6:30 p.m. Thanks again for being with us, and have a great week. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Let me hear a sound of victory in this parking lot. Hallelujah. We have the victory. The definition of victory is defeating an opponent or an enemy. And because victory belongs to Jesus, it belongs to us. Let me say that one more time. I said, because victory belongs to Jesus, we have the victory. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah. Worship with us this morning.
Who can stand against the Lord?
No one can.
No one.
Tim's. Let's declare it together. It belongs.
Of my heart
be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' precious name that we pray, let us all say amen and amen. Come on, lift up your voice and give God a praise one more time. Hallelujah. Didn't we enjoy that powerful worship on this morning? We thank God for our worship ministers who have blessed us this morning. We honor the Lord in the presence of our First Lady, Lady Mona, today. Come on, somebody, give her a shout out today. Hallelujah. To our sister pastors, Ella Perry and Sister Reynolds. Ella Perry and Sister Perry. In the absence of the Reynolds today, we want to keep them in our prayers. But we're so grateful today for all of you beautiful people who have come from your homes and your various destinations to this campus on today to worship the Lord with us and to give God glory for all of the things that he have done. And we definitely want to thank you who are watching virtually today, online, wherever you might be. We thank you so much from the bottom of our heart. We thank God for our extended virtual family who are watching from across the country. We thank God for your support, your very kind words of encouragement, comments that you share. We're so grateful and thankful for you on today. Listen, I know you probably warm my barum. Get straight to the word of the Lord, and I'm going to share with you what thus said the Lord, and we're going to pray, and we're going to let you go. I just want to just pause and let you know how grateful we are for you on today. Your support in every way, your financial support, your moral support, and your spiritual support. Those of you that have your Bibles, go with us to the book of Ezekiel. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 37. Ezekiel, chapter 37. And I'm going to begin reading at the first verse. Ezekiel, chapter 37. Beginning at the first verse. And the Bible reads, "The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. And again he said unto me, prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear ye the word of the Lord." I want to talk to you from this theme or subject today, and I'm going to break it down and explain it to you as we go on. But I want to focus on this particular theme or subject, and it's a prophetic word in your life today. And it simply says, your future is brighter than your present. Your future is brighter than your present. My God, that's enough to shout about right there. Now the message today is going to challenge your faith. And it may challenge a whole lot of our feelings. And not only our feelings, but even some of our opinions that we perhaps may have at the moment. But I want you to know that God's desire is to bless you with a life-changing word on today. Somebody tell God, thank you. Now notice, I said that God's desire is is to bless you. God's desire is to bless your life. And I want you to know about the God that we serve today. Everything about God has to do with blessing our lives. He would not send this word today if there wasn't a blessing in it for you. Now notice what the scripture says here in verse number 1. It said, Ezekiel said, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out. Listen, you're not here, or you're not listening to me today by accident. Anybody hearing what I'm saying? Ezekiel said, the hand of the Lord carried me out. And I came to tell you, you're not here today by accident. You're here today because the hand or the will of God have you here today. Anybody hearing me today? No, it's not by some special unique plan that you had today of just being a man in service on today, but you are here by the unique hand and the power of Almighty God for your life. If God had not willed you here today, bless God, who knows where you would be. Now notice here, even though this was God's doing or God's plan for Ezekiel's life, God did not shield Ezekiel from the initial gruesome sight of the situation. For God, the hand of the Lord was upon Ezekiel, and it carried him out in the midst of an ugly situation. It put him down in the midst of a valley that was full of dead men's bones. Amen. And how many of you out there like to hang out with skeletons? You like to be around skeletons. You got a skeleton hanging in your living room. You got a skeleton hanging in your bedroom as a memento or some piece of furniture. No, we don't even like skeletons. We don't like to look at skeletons. But here Ezekiel, he found himself in the midst of a valley full of skeleton bones. Anybody hear me? And sometimes it is the plan of God for us to see things, amen, just as they really are, even though they're messed up. Anybody hear me? You see, sometimes you really can't get help until you can see your problem. You really can't get help until you can see how bad and messed up things really are in your life. And I'm talking about what people, I'm not talking about what people want you to see, but I'm talking about the real problem, the real issues that you have going on in your life. You see, when God exposes and reveals the real problems that we have, amen, then we can deal with them. Anybody hearing me? You see, many times we can't see the issues, or we cannot see the problems that beset us, because we are so caught up in our surroundings. We're so caught up in the cares of this life. But one touch from the Master's hand, hallelujah, our eyes can come open. One touch from the hand of Almighty God, we can see things as they really are. Somebody say amen. I know there are some out there perhaps were like me, amen, at some time or another in your life, just seeing what I wanted to see. Anybody hear me? Especially as far as I was concerned. Isn't that something we can see with clarity when it comes to others? But our sight is vague when it comes to us. Hallelujah. You don't have to admit it. Just say amen. Hallelujah. But there are times in our life when purpose is involved. And it's there that God cuts through the chase, because God don't play with purpose. When purpose is involved, God will show you, amen, things as they really are. Ezekiel said, the hand of the Lord was upon me. Amen. It was God's doing. It was God's will that this happened in my life. Amen. I could not help it. I could not control it. But now I'm in the hands of the Lord. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and God carried me out, and God set me in the midst of this valley full of dead men's bones. Amen. It was there God placed him, in the valley full of bones, and what a sight that must have been. There is purpose in everything that God does. Somebody say amen. But sometimes God allows us to see, amen, just how bad things can be in our life. Amen. God allows us to see how bad things is in life. Now, God is one thing because he is God. But what he do and show you, amen, it's for your good, even though it don't look good. Anybody hear me? God said, what you're going through, what you see, and what you're dealing with right now, amen, when God's hands is on it. Hallelujah. It makes no difference what it look like, but when God's hand is on it, bless God, even though it don't look good, bless God, amen, God will pull some good out of it. That's why, bless God, you should not accept everything. You should not accept every word that comes your way. You should not accept every prophecy, even prophecy that come your way, amen, that comes your way just because it sounds good. Anybody hearing me? Hallelujah. Because many times some of the greatest moves of God in our history and in our life didn't start pretty. Hallelujah. It didn't start sounding good. It didn't start pretty to look at. Hallelujah to God. They were messy. It was messy, but it ended up gloriously. Somebody say amen. Many of us today are living proof of that. Just look at what God have done in your life. Can I get anybody to just witness with me that my life did not start out pretty? Life didn't start out pretty. Life didn't start out rosy. Life didn't start out, amen, as you see it right now. My God, I'm glad, bless God, you looking at me right now, but you don't know when. You looking at me now, but you don't know where I came from. Hallelujah. You weren't there when I was towed up from the flow up. You weren't there when I didn't have, man, what I have. I wish I had somebody today. Hallelujah. So it didn't start out pretty. It didn't start out nice to deal with or nice to look at. But look what the Lord have done. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah to God. Look what God have done. And I came to tell somebody this morning that everything you witness is not designed for you right then. Sometimes God must finish some things to make it suitable for you. And listen to me, my brothers and sisters, it may be in or a part of your life right now, but I came to tell you this morning, it may not be designed for your future. Oh yeah, you're in your life, you're dealing with it right now, but it may not be designed for your future. Somebody say amen. Moving on in our text. Amen. These were not just any bones. The Bible says in verse number 11 that these were the bones of the household of Israel. But we found out that this wasn't their future. Listen, just because you're in the fix you're in right now God wanted me to encourage somebody today to let you know, just because you're where you are right now, that this is not your future. Hallelujah. God got a way of taking messed up things, messed up people, messed up situations, and turning them things around. Somebody shout hallelujah today. Hallelujah. Yes, this is not your future. Ezekiel was set down right in the middle of a bunch of dead men's bones. Amen. Bones separated, bones that was scattered. And let me make a point here. The text speaks of bones, and there were many dry bones, dislocated bones, and separated from the joints. Amen. But here's a point I want to share with you. Amen. He talked about the dry bones, separated, dislocated bones, but he did not say that those bones was broken. Oh, hallelujah to God. No, he didn't say that the bones was broken. They may have been separated. They may have been out of order, but they were not broken. Somebody say amen. I hear the Holy Ghost saying that God would not give Satan the satisfaction of breaking his people. No, God wouldn't give Satan that pleasure of breaking his people. Amen. Punish them if you will, but you cannot break them. Punish them if you will, but you cannot destroy them. Somebody say amen. And I'm reminded of Jesus, who is now on the cross. He had been beaten, he had been bruised, he had been smitten, he had been spit on, and everything else that you can think of. Oh, but when you go through everything that Jesus went through, you cannot find that one bone in his body was broken. I wish I had somebody here. Oh, God, Father said, no, I won't give Satan the pleasure of breaking my son. Amen. I won't give Satan the pleasure of breaking my people. Somebody say amen. God asked Ezekiel a question here. He asked Ezekiel a question that he could not answer. Amen. He said, can these bones live? Do I have any witnesses out there this morning that would testify that sometimes you find yourselves in situations that you don't have answers for, but all you can say is, Lord, you know. Can I get a witness? Lord, you know. God, my God, you're looking at your situations and you don't know where the money is coming from to make it through the month. But are you just lift up your hand and say, Lord, you know. Don't know where my next meal is coming from, but Lord, you know. I don't know what I'm going to do with my children, but Lord, you know. I don't know the situation on my job, how it's going to work out, but Lord, you know. Hallelujah to God. Yes, we have questions that we don't have answers from. Oh, but we serve a God that knows everything. We serve a God that have already let us know that he will not leave us, nor will he forsake us. He said that he'll be with us always, even to the end of the world. And I found out, as long as I got God on my side, hallelujah, I can make it. I may not be able to see the next step in front of me, but when I got God in my now, when I got God in my present, I don't have to worry about the next step before me. All I got to do is believe God. I heard the scripture say, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Somebody give God a shout right where you are. Hallelujah to God. You see, it's God and his word that's going to produce the answer
answers for us anyway. So God told Ezekiel, he said, Ezekiel, prophesy to those bones and let the word work for you. Prophesy, speak over those bones, amen, and let the word work for you. Well, that's a good message for us even on today, that in the midst of your situations, God said prophesy to your situation and let the word work for you. Somebody say amen. God is saying prophesy to your life and let the word work for you. Your future may look grim, if you will, but God said prophesy anyway. Amen. Situations of this world may be chaotic and we don't know what's going to happen on tomorrow, but God said amen, prophesy to your tomorrow. God said the reason why a whole lot of things are happening the way they're happening now, because everybody is caught up in the present and hung up in the past. But God said, I'm looking for some more faith believers to start speaking to your tomorrow, to start speaking to your future, and telling your future that you will not be like my past. You won't even be like the present that I'm in now. Somebody ought to prophesy to yourself and say, my tomorrow is going to look brighter. A brighter day is coming. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah to God. So don't let the tragedies of today, don't let the tragedies of yesterday dictate your future. But somebody prophesy. Somebody shout, prophesy. Prophesy to your future. Somebody say amen. God is saying prophesy into your life and let the word of God work for you. Say amen, somebody. Hallelujah to God. The word got a way of taking grim situations and turning them around. Can I get a witness out there? Do I have anybody here that know what I'm talking about this morning? You see somebody that came out today. They came out of a broken and messed up situation. Life is in shambles. Life is in pieces. But thanks be unto God, there was something else and something better. Amen. Designed for your future. And it's just waiting on somebody. Somebody to speak a word and release it into your atmosphere. Where the Bible said, amen, it says to you on this morning that the word of the Lord is nigh you, is even in your mouth. Oh, somebody ought to fill your mouth with the word of God. You ought to fill your mouth with what God say. Stop dictating what CNN says. Stop dictating what Fox News is saying, CBS News, and all the rest of them are saying, and start speaking life in your atmosphere, life into your situation. Say yes, somebody. Somebody got to release it. Somebody got to turn it loose so the power of God can be manifested in your life. For God is saying today, he's saying prophesy. Somebody shall prophesy. Somebody shall preach. Somebody shall testify. Testify to your life. And I know it looks impossible, but say it anyhow. Say yes, Lord. If you're near somebody, amen, leave, holler at them and say, tell them to do it anyway. Come on, tell them to do it anyway. You may not know how it's going to happen, but say it anyway. Well, why, brother pastor? Well, because God says to do it. Amen. He told Ezekiel, and he began to prophesy, and he spoke with thus said the Lord, and that was the word that God gave him. He was basically telling Ezekiel to tell these bones that you're going to live. Hallelujah. I know you're dried up now. I know you're separated now. I know you're dislocated now. But he said, tell those bones, amen, that you're going to live. These bones was the household of Israel. And I want you to tell my people that you're going to live. I know Satan got your back up against the wall right about now. But God said you're going to live and not die to declare the works of the Lord. Somebody shout glory. Shout glory. Today, if you do it, and if you do it right, if you speak life, if you prophesy life, amen, if you prophesy healing, if you prophesy good health, if you prophesy prosperity, if you prophesy wealth in the lives of my people, and tell them they're gonna live and not die. Now they got something to hang on to. Say yes, somebody. And I somebody tell you that we serve a God of life and not of death. My God, I feel my help now. I feel the Holy Ghost here. And God told me to tell. He told me to speak the prophecy of Ezekiel 16 over your life today. Look at somebody and tell them, get ready. Come on, tell them, get ready. Hallelujah, tell them, get ready. Ezekiel 16, and I heard God say, he said, as for thy nativity, in the day that thou was born, thy navel cord, it wasn't even cut yet, neither was thou washed in water, and before they even suppled thee, thou was not salted yet, hallelujah, nor swallowed at all, amen, no eye pitied thee, amen, to do any of these things unto you, to have compassion upon you, but thou was cast out in an open field to the loathing of thy person in the day that thou was born. But look what God said. He said, but when I pass by you, when I pass by and saw your condition, when I pass by and saw you laying there, when I saw you in your messed up situation, I couldn't pass you by. I saw you polluted in your own blood, and I said to myself, there when you was in your own blood, I said, live. I said, live. I said, live. You're not gonna die today. You're not gonna die today. I speak life over your body. I speak life in your situation. You're not dying today. And you ought to tell your situation today that it's not gonna die on my watch today. Why? Because God is on my side. Say yes, somebody. Look over at somebody and tell them, I commend you. I commend you to live. I commend you to live. I commend you to live and not die. Hallelujah. If you gonna prophesy, you ought to speak life and not death. Y'all don't hear me. And Ezekiel, he spoke the word, and something began to happen. And I came to tell you, looking for. He's looking for your faith. It don't take God long to move in your life. Oh, God won't. If your faith and commitment to his word, say yes, somebody. Hallelujah. Listen, while you're trying to figure it out, God has already worked it out. And I want to tell you on this morning that your life is not beyond repair. Look over and holler at somebody and tell them, I don't care what you're going through in life. I don't care what your situation is. Your life is not beyond repair. We serve a God that is able, no matter how broken it may seem. It's not too hard for God. He's able to put every piece back together again. He's able to bring back together everything that's separated. Say yes, somebody. Say yes. Yes, Lord. Ezekiel. I got the clothes here. But Ezekiel, he began to prophesy, amen, to the bones, and the valley begin to shake. Isn't that just like God? Satan can shake up stuff to tear things up, but God can shake it up to put it back together again. God will not, he will not be defeated. What Satan meant for your bad, how many know God? He can turn that thing around. He can turn it around and cause it to work. Work for your good. Somebody shout glory. The valley was shaken. The bones was rallied. And the wind of God, it blew on those bones. And I understand what the old folk meant when they used to pray years ago, when they used to say, Lord, breathe on us. Lord, breathe on my child. Lord, breathe on my spouse. Y'all don't hear me. Say it. Yes, Lord. Breathe on that woman. Breathe on that man. Amen. In God's breath, there is life. God's breath, it is his spirit. And the spirit of God is that that giveth life. Hallelujah. The dried up, separated, dead men bones begin to come together. Every bone in its place unto what was a messed up situation. It began to take shape. Somebody ought to tell yourself, there's hope for me yet. Come on and tell yourself, there is hope for me yet. I can see it now. Things are looking better now. There is a brighter day in my future. Say yes, somebody. For look where the Lord have brought me from. When I was lost in my sins, doing everything that I thought I was big enough to do. But God, he reached out his saving hand and saved me before hell got me. He saved me before a bullet got me. He saved me before prison got me. He saved me before drugs got me. He saved me before the gangbangers got me. He saved me. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to tell yourself, there's hope for me yet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I may not be where you are right now, but he's still today. I'm so glad he accepted me in, and he's still working on my life. Is there anybody here? Is there anybody here that's still at the potter's house? Is there anybody here that's still on the wheel? And God is still molding you. God is still shaping you. God is still making your life. Say yes, somebody. Hallelujah. Is there anybody here who can testify that before I got to where I am right now, God had to crush me. He had to crush me. He pulled me down. He broke me down till I was nothing. Didn't have nothing. Just to build me all over again. Somebody shout glory. You see what you see right now, but you don't know where I came from. You wasn't there where I came from, but thank the Lord, thank the Lord, thank the Lord, I'm here right now. Say yeah, say yeah. God told me to tell you, if you speak the word, if you speak the word, you can change what's going to happen in your future. Y'all ain't saying nothing. As long as you're stuck in the now and the past, things will continue to happen the way that they're happening. But God got a way of changing things. Now hear God saying, speak life to your situation. God said, I know you better than that. Ha, shatatabo. Oroboshi kanada bahasa. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All you gotta do is speak the word, speak the word, and the word only, and you'll see things begin to happen and change in your life. So, what are you saying, Pastor Fanny? If you're going to prophesy to your future, you got to stop dictating the past and even some of your present. Y'all, I didn't get the two horns that time. There you go. All right. If you want to change things in your life, you got to stop speaking your past and even some of your present, and start speaking what thus said the Lord. Hallelujah. Start speaking his word. Start speaking his word. And the word that God gave us today, God says, speak life and not death. He said, don't look at your situation and say it hoping something happened. But do like he did in the book of Ezekiel, Ezekiel 16. Command life. He told that baby that was just born. Hallelujah. Neighbor card wasn't cut yet. Evidently the mama had died, but the baby was delivered, laying down there before the neighbor card was cut. And folk walking by, looking at the baby, there, nobody had pity, nobody had compassion on that baby. But God said, I cannot pass you by. My God, we used to sing a song a long time ago, Lord, please don't pass me by. Oh, gentle Savior, hallelujah, while on others thou art calling, please don't pass me by. Hallelujah. And my to live. Hallelujah. I command you to live. And I don't know about you this morning, but I command my house to live. I command my house to live. Hallelujah. Every devil, bless God, you got to get out of there because life is in my house. I command my house to live. Every germ, bless God, every virus, bless God, you every bad cancerous cell, you got to get out of there. I command you to live and not die. Woo! Hallelujah. Take authority. Take authority. Hallelujah. Take authority and command life. That's what God desires. He wants us to live. Anybody hear me? Hallelujah. I'm done. Lift those hands up right where you are. Lift them up. God want to bless. He want to bless your life today. Hallelujah. He want to bless your life today. I challenge you today to believe God. Somebody say that to yourself. Prophesy to yourself right now. Say, I believe God. I believe God. Hallelujah. I challenge you to believe God today. As you prophesy and speak over your life situations, I challenge you to believe God. Don't get caught up in how bad situations look. Hallelujah. But believe God. God got a way of standing up and showing himself. That's God, to where the odds don't even matter. Having to know, for a betting person, it would have been a bad bet to bank on the children of God when it was just 300 of them against over 100,000. That's a bad bet. Hallelujah. But what God wants you to do, God wants you to take the odds with him in a day. Hallelujah. Because as you know the story, those 300 of God's children defeated a mighty army. God got a way of stepping in the midst of the worst of worst situations. Cause it to work out for your good. Listen, even if you don't do it, God got a way of causing your enemy to kill themselves. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. So I challenge you with your hands lifted, eyes closed. I challenge you to believe God. Believe God today. Believe God today. Believe God today. And while your hands is lifted and your eyes is closed, I want you to speak Luke 1:37 over your life. That simply says, for with God, nothing will be impossible. Come on, say that. For with God, nothing will be impossible to me. With God, nothing will be impossible to me. Speak 2 Corinthians 5:7 over your life. That said, for we walk by faith and not by sight. For we walk by faith and not by sight. For we walk by faith and not by sight. While you're speaking over your life, speak Mark 9:23 over your life. That said, all things are possible. All things are possible to him that believe. All things are possible to him that believe. Go ahead and release your faith right now as I pray. Father, in Jesus' name. God, you are God that's omnipresent.
You're almighty, you're all power, you're omniscient, you're omnipotent. You're everywhere all at the same time. And God, I asked of you right now to minister to every person under the sound of my voice. Every car, every home, every vehicle. Meet them right where they are and minister to their spirits. In the name of Jesus. Increase our faith. Boost our faith. Help us, God, to believe you, to trust you in seemingly hopeless situations. Our world is in trouble right now. Chaos everywhere. But God, we're not caught up in what the world is doing. We're standing on your word. Your word said that you are a God of peace. And we receive peace in our hearts right now. Peace in our minds right now. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. God, help us to step out on faith and believe and trust you for whatever we need you to do in our life. You've given us the remedy today, and that's to speak your word, to prophesy. Prophesy your word to our future. Prophesy your word to our situation. Prophesy life, healing, health, prosperity, and wealth into our life right now. God, we do it in Jesus' name. And we thank you, God, for the fruit of your word being manifested back to us this day, here on this campus, here over the airwaves, under the sound of my voice. We thank you for increasing our life, increase of wisdom, increase of knowledge, understanding, increase, God, of the needs of in our life right now. We thank you for that, and we give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, open up your mouth everywhere. And just begin to tell God, thank you. Come on, tell him, thank you. Come on, release it out of your mouth. Tell him, thank you. Release it out of your mouth. And tell him, thank you. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for healing. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for souls that are being saved. Even right now, those whose hearts have been touched. And they're at the point of repentance right now. And by faith, we pray for their release, their breakthrough into new life. In Jesus' name, open up your mouth and begin to thank God right where you are. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to God. We give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name. Now everybody that was blessed today, bless God, give God glory today. Give God praise today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Listen, as always, it has been an honor. It has been my pleasure and privilege to have served you again today. Those of you that are here on the campus, those of you who are out over the airways connected, I thank God for each and every one of you, all of our partners from all over. Bless God, Mississippi, Georgia, Texas, California, all of you. God bless each and every one of you. We thank God for you so much. Listen, what you do, it keeps us encouraged. We are able to do what we do at the level that we are doing it at because you are praying for us, you are supporting us. You are encouraging us. And for that, I am so grateful. I am so thankful in Jesus' name. Listen, those of you that have not given your contributions, amen. Deacons, there are several with the offerings sticking out of the window. Amen. Let's get to them and serve them at this time. Hallelujah. God bless. Amen. The deacons are coming at this time. Hallelujah. Let's be faithful in our giving on today. God bless you. Y'all are so wonderful. Thank you. Let's be faithful in our giving. Church family members, let's do what we do.